All right, we're going to be installing the AltRider Adventure 2 pegs for the GS1200 and the GS1250.
These really are a fantastic upgrade from the OEM pegs. The larger size will help ease any fatigue and generally be more comfortable, but they're not so big that they might get in your way when you dab your feet on the ground.
We've seen pegs get so big they can be problematic.
They're customizable in that you can set a neutral setting, which is
close to 90 degrees to your bike, or you can add some additional camber
to help keep your feet on the pegs and give a little bit of extra leverage when you steer with the pegs. If you've ever watched any tutorials on riding off-road, you'll often hear them talk about steering with your pegs. A bit of camber can give you an edge if that's what you're looking for. They're also really a great looking set of pegs, available in black or silver.
So when you get your Adventure 2 pegs, they come with two pegs, right and left side obviously. You can tell the front because the engraved AltRider. This is the rider's right hand side and this is the rider's left side. Comes with a fit kit with all the hardware you need. These are a direct replacement for the OEM foot pegs and comes with 36
custom cleat screws.
These cleat screws really are a standout product compared to the other anything else on the market. They provide excellent grip while not chewing up your riding boots, especially compared to the pegs that have the sharp spikes or even set screws. In your fit kit, you'll receive two springs. The rider's right side is the gold one and the left is the silver.
Two 23 millimeter long bushings.
Two 9 millimeter long spacers. Two small spacers that are 4 millimeters long. Two M6 fasteners. Eight M6 washers, four washers that are 1 millimeter thick, and four washers that are 0.5 millimeter thick. These are for setting up the camber, if desired. I'll explain more about that later. You can see the difference in the washers. I have the 1 millimeter thick washers on the left and the 0.5 millimeter thick on the right. And if you order direct from AltRider, you'll receive resealable thread locker. This is a great little item you can carry with you when you go out riding in case needed.
This is a simple install and will only need a few tools. You'll need a flat blade screwdriver to remove the E-clip from the foot peg pin. Need a nose pliers to put the E-clip back on. 5 millimeter hex wrench, an external T6 Torx. If you don't have an external T6 Torx, a 5 millimeter socket will work. This is to drive in the custom cleat screws into the foot pegs. You also want a ratchet and you'll definitely want some thread locker. First, grab your flat blade screwdriver. You want to remove the E-clip from the foot peg pin.
There's many ways to remove the E-clip. I'll show you the best way with this specific E-clip. With the peg off the bike, just to make it easier to show, put the point of the screwdriver in this space here and give it a twist against the foot peg pin and you'll see it come off. You just want to do it thoughtfully so you don't lose your E-clip.
Because you will be reusing that E-clip.
This way you avoid bending the E-clip. Once you've got the E-clip off, you can push the foot peg pin out. It really comes off pretty easily. You will be reusing this foot peg pin and the E-clip. Go ahead and get both sides of your foot pegs off. Be sure to save both foot peg pins and both E-clips. Next, we'll be putting the cleats into the foot pegs. There's 18 for each foot peg. Get two drops of thread locker on the threads. Be sure to get it on the threads. Just do a couple at a time so it doesn't dry out. To each cleat to make sure it doesn't rattle out. After you get all the cleats screwed in, let's get them tightened. If you don't have an external T6 Torx, you can use a 5 millimeter socket. Tighten them down to 7 newton meters or 5 foot-pounds. Choking up on a 1/4-inch ratchet is a good estimate for 7 foot-pounds of torque. This is ready to go. Once you get the cleats in, you'll want to screw in camber adjustment screw. So you have really finite control over camber. Using just the 4 millimeter spacer puts you at neutral so that the pegs are
close to 90 degrees to your bike.
And that's how it's purchased from the factory. If you want a little bit of camber, we have 4 0.5 millimeter washers and 4 1 millimeter washers. To explain how this works, the foot peg pin goes through this hole and this fastener
pushes against the body.
If you have more washers in there, then it will push it out further from the clevis and give you a little bit more angle towards the bike, a little bit more camber, it's called. If you're not sure how much camber you want, if any, you can just start with neutral. That's how the bike comes from the factory. And then play around with adding two washers. You can see here, I used a 1 millimeter washer and a 0.5 millimeter washer just to give me a little bit extra camber. But today I'm gonna install it as neutral
just because that's how it comes from the factory.
Using a 5mm hex key, tighten to 10 newton meters or 7 foot-pounds.
We've got that installed. Next, we'll want to grab our spring.
23mm long bushing.
And the 9mm long spacer. So the way this goes,
the long bushing
goes through the footpeg body. Then the shorter, fatter spacer goes around there for the spring. And then the spring goes in this hole, hooks on there, and then rests around these two spacers, and this will attach to the clevis. We want to grab our footpeg pin and E-clip. This is really easy. It does take just a little bit of pressure to push against the spring. So you want to hook the spring against the bottom part of the clevis like this, and then you'll have to use a little bit of pressure to push against the spring and line this hole up. You'll have to do a little bit of
down and in.
It's not that bad. You can see there the hole is lined up. Once it's lined up, push your footpeg pin through. Initially, you just need to get the top part in, and then you can line up the bottom part, and it should go right there. It should go in pretty easily. If you have difficulty, you can use a punch pin that's a smaller diameter than the footpeg pin and push it up through the bottom to get the holes aligned. Then you want to take your E-clip and get it on the footpeg pin. Just make sure it's properly seated. And here's the best way to put the E-clip back on. This time I'm going to use needle-nose pliers. Just get it started with your finger so it's on there a little bit. Put the pliers on the footpeg pin and on the E-clip and just squeeze, and it goes right on. Same thing with the rider's left side.
Be sure to get 2 drops of thread locker on each cleat.
Get all the cleats screwed in. All right, the longest part of this install is just getting these cleats all in place, but it is definitely worth it. These are some really nice footpegs.
Tighten them down to 7 newton meters or 5 foot-pounds.
Same thing on this side. We want to get our camber adjustment screw installed. 4mm spacer puts the peg at neutral.
Using a 5mm hex key, tighten to 10 newton meters or 7 foot-pounds.
Next, grab your spacer and bushing.
Same concept. This goes through the peg body. The shorter, fatter spacer goes around there. And then the silver spring is for the rider's left side. This part goes into the peg body, sits around the two spacers. This will wrap around the clevis. Grab our footpeg pin and E-clip.
We want to get the spring wrapped around the clevis, like so. And then we're just going to use a little bit of pressure to get it in position. The footpeg pin in place. Get all the holes lined up, and it goes in pretty easy. And the same thing with the E-clip. In place, grab a tool to push it on, and just make sure it is fully seated. All right, that's it. You're ready to ride. If you've got any questions or comments, please let us know.